So if you finish creating your beautiful spreadsheet and you're ready to share it with the world or just share it with a few people, you can do that through Google Sheets. We're going to show you how to do it right now. And there's a couple different ways to do it. So what we'll start out with doing is we'll just go up to the green share button. So that's always there on any Google Sheet that you create. Click that, and then you get a little sharing dialog that comes up. And this has two general options on it. It's controlling who you share it with. So this would be adding specific people or groups, or controlling just how it can be accessed to anyone that has the web address for it or the URL. Now we'll start out with people with access, but notice when you pull up your sheet, here it probably doesn't say anyone with the link. I set a lot of my spreadsheets to that so that when other people see these videos, they can also access the sheet. So beware if yours says that right now, you may have a setting that you don't want. Mine's that way on purpose. But we'll go up to the people with access. So this right now, this is the main account. This is my account that you're seeing. And it's just showing that it's already shared with me because I'm the person who created it. So of course I have access to it. But what we're going to do is we're going to say, let's add Michael. So Michael is this window on the right. I have them both up so we can see working back and forth. And it's Michael Bazalian. And we'll go into the window that says add people in groups. I know Michael's email address. That's going to be the easiest way. You can also just type his name though. And once you get enough letters in there, it will auto populate and we'll click on Michael. All right, so now we're at the next step of adding this specific person, and it brings us to this window where we have three choices. So these three choices are very important, and they go from least permissions to most. So if you give them editor permission, they can basically do anything that you can do in the sheet. So be careful with that, right? If it's a trusted person, maybe you want to do that. But if you're not sure, consider one of these lower levels. So if you just make them a commenter, we'll do that on him just for illustration, but I want that to come back. He can right click in certain cells and kind of ask questions and you can reply, but he can't edit the contents. And then if you make this other person a viewer, they can see the spreadsheet, but they can't change anything. So we'll make them a commenter and we're going to click notify people. And then we're just going to tell Michael, here's the spreadsheet we talked about. Okay, so this is going to be what goes into the body of an email that's sent to Michael. The last option that we don't need to do is copy link. So that would be to take the link, which is the address, put it on the clipboard, and then you could paste it, say, like into a message that you wanted to send him. But that would be redundant with how we're doing it right now, because when you click send, we'll go over to the right. This is Michael's email inbox, and you'll see he gets a notification of it through his email. So when he comes in, so now I'm acting like Michael. I'm over on the right side of the screen. We'll click on this email. And it's, here's a message, here's a spreadsheet we talked about. And if he clicks on open, then it will bring up the Google Sheet for him in his Google account. We're going to show you another way to do this though, before we click on that, is that if we go to his Google Drive, so in this tutorial we're using Google Drive, there are a few other file storage apps that you can use Google Sheets in, or Google Docs or Slides. I know you can use them in Dropbox or Box, but typically you're using them in Google Drive. So I'm going to show you how this works in this environment. So when you go to shared with me on the left-hand side, this is everything that's been shared with me. Notice it's all just things that are shared by my other account, because really this is just an account that I made up. But the most recent one is the spreadsheet that I just shared. So this helps to organize them in Google Drive. You can also copy them into your main drive, right? So if we right click on it, we could add a shortcut to Drive. That's how you do it there. And then that will be linking to this. So it'll be the same file, but you can just see it. If all of your workflow is in the Drive and you have a folder structure that you'd like to work with, that's what you would do. But we're going to leave it here. We'll double click on it to open it in Sheets. And Sheets looks a little bit different on the right because of the people, other people that are in the sheet are the person in this account. So these icons, you see this is an M and then this is a picture of me. I just never uploaded a picture to the Michael account. But this is where you can see the other people that you're sharing this with. So there's one other person. You can chat directly with them here if you click on that. But what the comment only permission does is if you wanted to do something like say in about that particular cell, and I can direct this to me, I can say this looks too high. And if I assign that to Adam Steinforth, it seems important, right? I'm giving myself an assignment. If I come over to my sheet here, oh, I'm on the wrong tab. I'll go to the unformatted tab, which is where the other person is. And I see that there's a comment. They said it looks too high. I can hit a reply here. I should probably do the best practice and assign it to him. And reassign to Michael. And Michael comes over, so it sees that I said it was okay. So he's going to click his check and it resolves that comment and it goes away. So when you are collaborating in Google Drive, the comment feature makes it, gives a lot of nice structure to a dialogue where you can talk about specific things in Google Sheets and resolve them. But since I gave this Michael a comment only, if I go into cell, let's say F9, one, I don't even see it on the left-hand side. So I can see a person that has edit privileges, you can see their active cell move around, but you can't see that for someone that just has commenting privileges because you can be in their cell and it doesn't matter. But if I go into F9 and I start typing, nothing happens. So you can't edit the sheet. Now let's do one thing else. If you go and you share and you want to give Michael access, but you want to control it a little bit. So we will change him to editor. We'll click save. And now let's refresh Michael's so it doesn't say comment only. Okay, there we go. Now both active cells are being shown on both screens. And if I go into F12 and I type DDDDDDD and hit enter, it does edit the cell, so it updates the contents. We'll go in here and we will delete this. And then one extra thing that I wanted to show you is I said that we wanted to give Michael edit access, but we do want to control it a little bit. So let's go back to Adam's account here. And let's say we don't want him to modify the formatted version. It just looks too nice. Let's say you spent a lot of time on it and you're proud of it. What you can do is you can click on that arrow and do protect sheet. And then you can enter a description for that range, but you can take the entire sheet. Let's just call it important. Set permissions on it and you can remove edit access from Michael on the entire sheet, or you can do it just within a range of the sheet. But we'll do it for the entire sheet and click done. And all of the styling in the menu bar is grayed out now, so you can't change it. So Michael can use the other worksheets, but just not this one. All right, so let's go look at some of the other options in sharing. That covers sharing with specific people, but you can also share with groups. So let's go back to Drive. We will click on these 9 dots. And we will look at the concept of groups. And in here, we've named 2 marketing groups for some reason, and production. These each have an email address associated with them. We will go back to Sheets. Let's say we want to share this with the marketing group. And that email address comes up. You can see that it's a group based on this icon here. We'll left click on it. And this is a similar thing where you can give that entire group, let's just give them viewer permissions and say something like, oh, here's the quarterly marketing report, right? Even though what's in the spreadsheet is inventory data. We'll ignore that. What you could do, you could change this. You could share it with production, right? Production. There. So you can share with individual people or groups with that, what I'm calling the first option. But if you go down, so I just went back, this is the sharing window that comes up. The second option is called general access. So this is how you control what happens when anyone goes to this link. All right, so when you look up in the address bar, this long string of characters here identifies this specific spreadsheet. And you can tell Sheets, hey, look, if anyone on the internet comes to that URL, you would have had to give it to them because it's long and random. They're not going to guess it. This is what I want to have happen. So when you look down here, this right now is set to anyone with the link can be a viewer. So I take most of my spreadsheets, I give it that setting because I'll do a video or write a web page and I want to share the spreadsheet with them. So this spreadsheet is shared from several different pages. And what I've done is I've said, clicked on this, and you can do, you can lock it down and say, anyone that comes to the link, it doesn't matter. You have to just look at these permissions above. Okay, so that's not what I've done. That's the most restrictive. The second one is control it where anyone at your company gets a specific type of treatment. But the widest one is anyone with the link. So that's what we have right now. And then you'll probably recognize these roles, right? What I've done is anyone with a link can see it. So I make them a viewer. Let's copy this link and I'll show you what that does. So if you open up, we'll do an incognito window. So this is just a window in Google Chrome that doesn't know who's using it. So it's not signed into a Google account. If you come to that window and you paste the link to that spreadsheet in, you're able to see it. You have to sign in to be able to copy it, but you can move around. You can go to different worksheets, and Google at this point doesn't even know who you are. You're not logged into a Google account. And if you go to file, if you were signed in, you could make a copy. So that's what I tell most of the people that do that use my spreadsheets, is that you make a copy, it goes into your own Google Drive, and you have a completely independent copy at that point that you have full permissions to. So we will close this and we'll just look at one more thing. And this is, can be an important consideration depending on what you're doing, but that least restrictive, so the most permissive permissions, called an editor, they can also change the permissions for other people and they can share it. That's turned on by default, so just keep that in mind. And then this, you can control whether the viewers and commenters can see the option to download, print, and copy. I've always left these on, but you may want to turn them off for different reasons. So that covers how to share your spreadsheet. Next, we'll go to a bit more of an advanced level and talk about how to create your own functions. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching. It's nice to have you along.